mother wanted to say, because she never said nothing. But 21 years she has served the Georgetown area school district, and I think it may be more than that, because she taught social studies for 21 years, and she also worked with adjudicated youth and teaching them social studies as well. We all know her as the principal of Roosevelt Alternative School, Walker Street. We also know her as a child guard, and we know her as one dynamite speaker who's on an In Your Neighborhood. The round table. Next is to ask for that form introduction given out to God and grace and peace to multiply this evening. How humble that the opportunity to come before you tonight for a number of reasons. As I was reflecting on today, I was thinking about the fact that before this even became a national holiday, I was one of the people down there in D.C. when Stevie Wonder was saying happy birthday to you and protesting, trying to get it a national holiday. So it gives me great joy to be able to see the fruit of our efforts and for a number of years becoming a national holiday. And I want to commend all of you who have come out tonight. I want to recognize my parents who are here tonight, Deacon Chester and Charlotte Simpson. When I get to that part about the rules for about parents, if you have a question about what I say, I'll make sure that they're here so you can verify what I'm saying. I want to acknowledge the clergy here, certainly my co-labors from Zion, as well as other co-labors in the house, to my fellow colleague, Mrs. Hodges, principal of Coleman School, to our sister who beat us to retirement, Mrs. Michelle, the honoree of the evening, to Mrs. Granger, who has been faithful to open and close the TV and radio ministry these years, sitting on the front, and Missionary Ellison, who's traveling with me on the farm field. And I can go on and on and on, but you know, the total I had about 2 minutes. The theme of this evening is living the dream. And I want to speak for a few moments from this subject, purpose colliding with destiny. I'm a product of the baby boomer and was living during the civil rights era. I was not a witness during the series of events, as I said, that led up to Dr. King's birthday becoming a national event. There are many parallels that exist today in regards to Dr. King's platform. The poor are still with us. During his time, we had the Vietnam War, and now we're engaged in the war with Iraq. The plight of the have versus the have-nots is still a familiar phenomenon in our time. The issue of inequity in our nation's schools, Brown versus the Board of Education of Topeka, Kansas, and today the No Child Left Behind mandate that indeed continues to leave many behind. Reflecting on Dr. King's principles of nonviolence, he patterned his philosophy after Mohandas K. Gandhi and Jesus Christ. He was a drum major for justice and stood firm against injustice and inequality in any form. My question tonight is, how are you keeping the dream alive? I see you out here tonight. I know that many of you have been out in other programs, but outside of the program, what are you doing to keep the dream alive? Uh-huh. We are living in a time when there is a disconnect. Today, we are faced with new slave masters. According to Bishop George D. McKinney in his book, The New Slave Masters, drugs have hurt our families. They harm us physically. They ensnare us and tie us into knots. Materialism. It's all right to have things, but the question is, do things have you? Parents, young people want your time, and you keep substituting your time with things. Racism in America. and gave